The real estate trends we saw at the outbreak of the pandemic show no signs of letting up, with metropolitan hubs bearing the brunt of the mass exodus. Daryl Fairweather, the chief economist of real estate firm Redfin, has seen this firsthand.
That have been hit the hardest are San Francisco, the very core downtown area, and Manhattan. Those are the places that are really expensive, and people start to question why they're spending so much money for so little space.
I think many families could do a lot better by moving out of the big city and into the suburb areas.
Brian Kennard decided to turn his back on his hometown of Phoenix, having watched the pandemic tear through his neighborhood and the political fallout that came with it.
It's like the whole fabric of this country is just being torn apart, and especially in big cities.
And Brian is not alone. Families across the U.S. realize the suburban life is more appealing than ever.
It used to be that people were willing to sacrifice square footage or more outdoor space in order to be really close to work. But now that the pandemic has normalized remote work, more and more people are selling those kinds of properties and looking to the suburbs or to more rural areas where they can get more space for their budget.
As normalcy seems ever more attainable, will city living boom again?
So I think that demand for urban cores and some of these condos will bounce back, but they're not going to be the most desirable places that they were before the pandemic.